Welcome back friends. In this video, we are going to see how to set up a billing system using Eclipse. I used Eclipse version 2019 iPhone 12. This version I used, I am going to use the same version. I think the latest version of Eclipse expecting Java 11. Okay, but I am using Java 8. That's the reason I am using this version. Okay, let me download this version of Eclipse. Go to Google, download Eclipse. Click the first result. Scroll down. Here you can see Eclipse 2019-12. This is our version. Click this. I want to download the zip file. So we need to select this option. You should not select this. We need to select this option. Click that. Once you click, you will be getting this page where you can download that as zip file. Click this. Click save. It start downloading now. After successful download, go to the download location. Extract this file. I want to move this to my Eclipse workspace. Okay, I'm going to open this. Keeping this Eclipse folder anywhere in your operating system, that is your wish. Okay, in this workspace we need to give a workspace location. I want to use this location as my workspace. I'm copying this path, then pasting here, then click launch. Like that, whatever path you want as a workspace, paste that path and launch it. If you open Eclipse very first time, it will show like this. Click this welcome window. Now I want to import my project. Okay, here click import project. Import project. Before that, I want to download my billing system, right? For that, go to pinepad.in, click download. Click download button. Go to Eclipse workspace, save it there. Then go to downloader location. Extract this, extract here. You will be getting billing system iPhone main. Please change it to billing system. Don't keep it as billing system iPhone main. Please rename to billing system. Don't forget to rename this to billing system. Once you renamed, you have to import. In the Eclipse, you can see import project. Click import project. There is one option called Maven. Click Maven. Existing Maven project. Click existing Maven project. Click next. You have to paste the path where your project is available. This is my project location. Copy this location. Then paste it here. Then click finish. It will show like this. Then click finish. Now it is importing. My billing system is getting importing. The Eclipse right corner, bottom right corner, you can see it's a downloading and a building. It's completed now. There are some error I can see. What is that error? I think we need to set up the JRE. I think Windows preferences, Java, JRE, In the JRE location, you need to change. Remove it, add, next, then directory, click directory. You have to select program files, Java, JDK. You need to select JDK, okay, not JRE. Once you select JDK, automatically JRE set. Automatically JRE set here. Finish, then apply and close. Okay, now some errors are gone, but still some errors are available. Let's see what is that error. It's showing some errors in get first name, get last name, lock. The reason is, in a billing system, we are using Lombax framework. In order to integrate Lombax framework in Eclipse, we need to follow some steps. Then only this compilation error will resolve. Okay. Now we're going to see how to set up a Lombax in Eclipse. This is my Lombax artifact. Once we added this Lombax artifact here, automatically Lombax library downloaded in M2 folder. Downloaded in M2 folder. Okay. All the jars available in .m2 folder in our operating system. Go to that M2 folder that is available under user. User, this is my user. Under that you can see M2 folder. Go to repository. There is a one folder called, I think it's org. Yeah, it's org only. Share project Lombax. Go there, Lombax. Here you can see Lombax 1.8.8. Go to the latest version of Lombax 1.18.8. You can see here Lombax jar file, right? Copy this path, open command prompt. Go to that path. Once you go inside this path, we need to execute one command to install Lombax in Eclipse. Java-jar. Then copy this jar file and paste it here. Then hit enter. It will open one window. Click OK. It asking where is your Eclipse installed. Okay. Through this specify location, we need to tell. Click specify location. My Eclipse is available here. This is my Eclipse. We need to tell this Eclipse location. Copy this path, then paste it here. Then click install update. If the Lombax successfully installed, it will show this particular message, installed successfully. Then quit installer. Now we have configured Lombax successfully in Eclipse. Now restart the Eclipse file and restart. It's opened Eclipse. Still the error is exist. Project clean. After saying project clean, the error was gone. Still you are seeing that Lombax error. Do this project clean. Still if you are seeing after restarting the Eclipse, still you are seeing the error. Just to do project and clean, the Lombax error will go. Okay, now we don't have any error. Now we need to start the server. Before starting the server, I want to show the database. The database, we don't have any tables, right? We don't have any tables. In the resource, under resource folder, we have a DB folder. Under DB, we have a migration folder. In our billing system project, I have configured the Flyway framework. Flyway framework execute these SQLs. When you look at these SQLs, we have a table definitions, all table definitions. In this SQL, we have a role data. Whatever role I am maintaining in this project, those roles available here. This is an insert statement for role table. Then this is for creating a JW token table. This is for storing some static data in a system codes table. About the system code, I will going to explain later. I will going to post separate video for that. Okay. So these are the some SQLs I want to execute when start the server. While starting the server, it will execute this query and create the table and insert the data and create the JW token table, then insert this data. This query executed by our Flyway framework. Now I want to start the server. Go to Building System Application, right click, Run as Java Application. I am getting some accessing error. The reason is DB access error. I am getting some DB access error. Reason is, when you look at application normal file, I am mentioning username as a billing, but in my local database I created a username as a billing-admin. That is the reason it's giving the error. Now again I'll going to start the application. Right click, Run as Java application. This time it will go successfully. Let's see. The Flyway is executing. You can see some create table, alter table commands. Now the building system is successfully started. When you look at the database, refresh the table, you can see all the tables are created. I want to test our application is running properly or not. For that, I created one endpoint called ping. I have created one endpoint called ping. When I call this endpoint, this message will print. That meaning our server is running well. Let's check that. What is the endpoint? Full endpoint, API public test, API/public/test. After that, we need to give ping. Go to browser, localhost :8901/test/ping. It's giving forbidden error. Application is working, but it's giving forbidden error. By default, this page is not accessible in public. Okay, such a way we have configured our application. In our application, we cannot access any endpoint directly. That endpoint must be authorized. If you want to access the endpoint directly without authorization, we need to configure this endpoint. We need to tell to Spring Security, hey, this endpoint should be accessible without authorizing. Okay, that thing we need to tell. That is missing. That's the reason it's giving forbidden error. For that, go to securityconfig.java file. There is our method called configure method. Here we need to tell this particular endpoint I want to access without authorization. /ping. Okay, I have added. Once we added this particular endpoint is publicly accessible. Okay, server is started now. Again, I'm going to hit this URL. I think server is not started properly. I'll stop the server. Server is started now. Let's check now. I think some mistake I did, API, we need to give slash here. One more slash we need to give. Now, we are able to access this endpoint. The problem is, I missed one slash. Okay, that's the reason I'm not able to access. After starting the server, I am able to access the endpoint. Now our server is running well. We have 100% completed the billing system project setup. There are 6 videos, I think. There are 6 videos I have posted. Please watch those videos for billing system setup. Okay, this is a part of one video. There are 6 videos I have posted. Please watch those things. If you're not able to set up the billing system, also please comment me. Definitely, I'll going to help you out. All those video links, all those billing system setup video links, I have given in the video description. Please take a look. Okay, that's it, guys. Until then, bye bye from Suresh. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.